my first attempt at bringing this tool to the attention of my local neighbors and friends. My name is Chris Whiteleather. I live in Geneva, New York, which is in Ontario County. And taxlookup.net is an interesting little tool that collates information on property size, property values, tax rates, and tax payments throughout New York State. It does not include every county in New York State. The county list is as you see it here. And this is not every county in New York. For instance, I own a property in Essex County, which should have been listed here. However, it is not. I also own a property in Ontario County. So we're going to use those as examples today. So the homepage will show you this. You have a list of counties, a button for view all counties, which only shows you the counties that are already here. So don't be tricked by this. So for those of us in Ontario County, you would click Ontario. Within Ontario County, there are several school districts. So the information is split out by school district. Within Ontario County, we have Geneva, which is Geneva City Schools, where I live, Marcus Whitman, Naples, and Wayland-Cohocton. So let's go with Geneva. When you hit Geneva, you're brought up to a search page. It gives you the information that you would need to contact or make payments for the Geneva City School District taxation system. But it's interesting that the search page allows you to find other information. You can search by street address, you can search by owner's last name or business name, by tax map number, or by bill number. So my address is 534 Castle Street in Geneva. However, they only want street number and street name. They don't want the word street. So you need to know that you're looking for 534, make sure that's it, and you're looking for Castle, Castle Street. Don't type street or ST or AVE or anything else. And if we hit search, we get one property at that one address. And here you see my wife's name. If we click that, we get to see the property address, the account number, the tax bill number, the Swiss code, the school code, school district for whatever reason is blank here, the tax map number, and this is very important information. This will allow you to go to the county clerk in Ontario County and find a paper version of all information regarding this address. They're also listed as the owners, my wife, myself, and our address once again. They show the payment history, and this is the tax payment history. Okay, the tax payment history, and it shows that we have a tax due of zero because we pay our taxes on time like good little soldiers. There's other information available on this page, such as property details, which is very handy because it gives a distinction between the land assessment, which is essentially the dirt under your house, versus the total assessment, which is the dirt under your house plus your house. It also shows you acreage. Now, on smaller properties, this will be listed as the frontage, so how many feet across the front, and the depth, how many feet along the side, so you can calculate the square footage. In our case, we have it's a non-linear, non-rectangular lot, so it was easier for them to just put in the acreage of 4.1 acres in the city of Geneva. So that was under the property details. Under the levy details, it will show you, in addition to the property tax you pay, it will show you the valuation for your house, the rate and the amount you pay for the school tax and the library tax. So for instance, in my case, we pay $5,289.88 in school tax, even though we don't have any kids in the school. We also pay $233.22 in a library tax, even though we rarely use the library. The library was recently, in the last, oh my gosh, 5 years, made a public library, which means it's supported by tax dollars, which means you pay for it whether or not you use it. So I suggest you use it as much as possible. Also on this page, there's information about the penalty schedule. Hide those. And the penalty schedule shows if you were late with your payment, how much your penalty is going to be. And then it shows the sort of running cost of the penalty added to your tax payment, and how much you owe. These are all black, they're not red, which means we don't owe anything, and that's up here by proven by the tax due is zero. And that is the information that you get on a specific piece of property. Additionally, you get information through the years. So it's as high as 2021. In other words, we have information for 2021, and it goes back as far as 2008. We've owned the property for much longer than this, so all of this will have our name on it. But it does still show the changes over time in the valuation of the property and the tax rate and the tax you're paying. For instance, in 2021, the dirt under our property was worth $72,000. That was the dirt in 2021. If we click on 2008, it turns out that the dirt under our property was $49,000. So the jump from $49,000 to $72,000 is significant. Why the dirt under the property has increased so much, and yet we've added nothing to the dirt, and we're not growing crops on it, is a mystery. But this is great information to have. It shows that stuff that you didn't make any improvements to, you can't improve dirt, right? But the price of it still goes up. Now, I'm not saying that an improvement to your house, if you pave your driveway or add an extension or update your heating system, I'm not saying that those don't add to the total assessment, but nothing you can do can add to the value of the dirt, and yet it goes from 49,200 in 2008 up to $72,000 in 2021. As far as I can tell, it's the same date, the same dirt. The acreage hasn't changed. Anyhow, this is a nifty little system that helps you find out information on your property, but also information on other folks' property. So if you don't want to search on the street address, you want to search on the owner's last name because he's your neighbor. And let's see my neighbor. My neighbor is Smith. It brings up all of the Smiths, not your neighbor, not all of the Smiths related to my neighbor, but all of the Smiths within Geneva and the Geneva City School System in Ontario County. Now, my neighbor is Raymond R. Smith. And when I click that, it brings up that particular property. But it also allows me to take information, I'm going to copy that, and go back to Smith, Raymond R. And it should have shown me everything listed for Raymond R. Smith. But apparently it didn't. That's interesting. Oh, so apparently Raymond Smith's property is now all listed under Charlene. So if you do list a Smith with a first name and a last name, it will give you all the properties that they have around you. And Charlene Smith, bless her soul, she is the owner of all of these properties. So there is quite a bit of versatility in this system. And again, tax years now seem to be from 2021 back to 2008. And in every indication, they list the tax map number. So if you're looking for a particular property at the county court there in Canandaigua, you can find physical paper representations of the properties by using these tax map numbers. The bill numbers don't really help you that much, but the tax map number will help you find surveyor's documents and plat maps, etc. So there you have it. That is taxlookup.net, or as I've always called it, and as it is still known, the Allen Tunnel Corporation website, and it is taxlookup.net with several counties in New York State listed, a lot of them here in our area of the Finger Lakes. Anyhow, I hope that gives you some idea of the tool available and that you will explore it, and you can explore it anonymously. You don't need to log in. And this is not an app that you need to download to your phone. It is simply available on the web as a web address. And it is all public information. This is not proprietary, private information. This is public information. Anyhow, I hope that helps. Take care.